amazing border crossing. Not too many cars. So far, so good. Okay. Maybe let's just go here in the middle. Oh my god, life is great. Let's get out of here. I'll stop somewhere past the border before they change their mind. And then I'll explain to you everything what happened. Welcome to New York, the Empire State. Yay! Chile, we're in. I just can't believe what just happened. Anyway, I'm gonna pull over now. Chile, we're here. We're in the United States. This is exciting, another country, and that's a big one. We'll be here for a while. So this is Buffalo. Is there any way to park? I'm not sure. Can I park here? I'm not sure, but I'll try.
I can't believe it. It just, everything went nice and smooth. So, that was a big surprise, actually. So I entered the border on Aussie passport. If you are entering on Aussie passport with this ESTA visa, which is like online application, you're allowed to stay in the country for 3 months. If you go to the embassy to get the visa, like I did, normally you're allowed to stay in the country for 6 months. But when I said to the immigration officer that my situation, that I want to, you know, do the loop across the United States, that I want to go back to Canada, I want to go to Alaska, come back to Canada, and then go across United States to Mexico, well, it will take me 1 year. So they just issued me a visa for 1 year. So I can go in and out for 1 year. I'm like, with no problem. I just can't believe this happened. This is fantastic. Ah, I don't need to worry about extensions and stuff. And additionally, they didn't ask me anything about the bike. I mean, like, they didn't even ask papers, registration papers for Chile, like nothing. We just like went past and they didn't check anything. They didn't check the bike, nothing. Just, do you have anything to declare? No, off you go. Wow. It was so easy, you know? It was so hard to get this visa, and now everything just went nice and smooth, and I'm so relieved. Well, welcome to United States.
Okay, so now I'm gonna go to see if I'm able to see Niagara Falls from this side. But first we need to find parking. Oh wow. That's a rough river, hey? Huh.
Right, are you ready? We're getting closer. Ta-da! So this is the view you get from the US side.
Thank you.
completely different perspective, right? You get so much closer. And much wetter here. Not as visible as from the other side, but like you just get really close to them, to the edge. First night in the US I spent in a motel. This is my premium room for like $80 with a breakfast. Pretty good deal. Much cheaper than Canada, I tell ya. So as yesterday I had a beautiful weather, today it's raining. And it doesn't look like it's gonna clear up for the next few days, so I just need to keep going in the rain. And I was super excited about today because today I'll be going through the region where Amish people live. And normally they will have little shops and businesses, but it is Sunday, so I reckon they won't be working today, and it's raining, so I don't think they'll be out. But anyway, I will drive through this region regardless. So now I'm gearing up, you know, the wet weather liner, the cold weather liner, all of that. It's gonna be an interesting ride, I reckon.
Sexy socks.
And we're good to go.
Have a good day.
Oh dear, it's so cold and wet. Anyway, I stopped here because I saw this carriage on the display. So you can see these are the carriages Amish still use. Look at the wheels. Not even rubber, it's just timber and steel. That's how you enter. And that's the suspension. That's all timber. Interesting, eh? Look at this truck! It's got the wheels elevate, and how does it work? And it's from Hanson. That's so cool.
sun came out, finally. Today, it's a transiting day. I've got 500 kilometers to do today, and I'll be doing through this. This is actually, someone recommended me this road. It's nice, it's a bit remote, it's going through nice towns, it's a bit windy and quiet. So I'll be doing that for probably around 100Ks. And then, I'm gonna have to hop on the highways here and there. So I'm heading to Philadelphia, well, very close to Philadelphia today, where I'll be staying with my high school friend and her family. Who's this? Who are you guys? Deer? Hi. They're gone. I think it was deer. Yeah, like a female deer, or just a small deer. We've got a little bit of gravel. We got everything today. The Bridgestone Adventure Trail, they ain't bad on this slippery gravel. I'm quite impressed. They have a good traction. Hold on, focus, Kinga, where are we going? This way. Such a pleasant ride. I love it. Maybe it's in total, I don't know, maybe 30 miles? I don't know, I didn't pay attention, but this is really cool. And I've got a perfect weather. Well, the gravel is a bit wet, but it's not a problem. Oh, lucky it's not raining now. And we've got the sun. We can admire all the, you know, last leaves for this season. They're still on trees. In different shapes and colors. How's that? Totally forgot to mention that I've received a new camel tank from Camel ADV products. So the first one I've been using for 10 years. I had it on my previous GS and then I moved it to Chile. So I've done around 180,000 maybe in total on it. And recently I just had leakage from the hoses. So guys, send me the new one. It's one of the last ones from the stock because, you know, 800GS is not produced anymore. So I'm very pleased to have the new camel tank on board. Brand new, with a smiley face, of course. So this is a 7-liter auxiliary tank.
the way it works, it's got this brilliant vacuum system, so the fuel empties the camel tank first and then it goes to the main tank. Excellent. Simple, but such a great solution. So in total, with both tanks, Chili is able nearly to do 500 km, which is very handy on round the world trip. Oh my god, this road is amazing. Within half an hour, I saw five deers. Like five. In half an hour. Like 3 months in Canada and I haven't seen even one. So this is a pretty good entry to USA. And we're back on the pavement and I think that will be end of the gravels for today because I really have a lot of kilometers to done. Well, sorry, miles. I have a lot of miles to be done. And I need to get a filly today before it gets dark. I was going to show you the camel tank when it's like a lot nice and flash and clean. It's too late. So let's do this. So let's do this for now.